This is a shoe print from a crime scene.
The first thing I would tell a student when they walk into a crime scene is don't step on anything and don't touch anything. My name is Thomas Mauriello. I'm a senior lecturer here at the University of Maryland Department of Criminology and Criminal Justice. As I teach Introduction to Criminalistics, and it's a combination of criminal investigation and forensic science, so I'm not trying to make scientists out of them. I'm trying to get them to understand how science can help them in their investigation process. Leaders, make sure that the documents start getting filled out improperly. Don't just say gun. What kind of gun? What's the serial number? Okay, crime scene 1 and 2. Let's go downstairs. Each student is assigned to one of the 3 full-size crime scenes we have on campus. One's an office scene, one's a bedroom scene, and one is a vehicle next to the building here.
It may be drug-related, but it's not drugs.
The significance of the students processing the full-size crime scenes are that they're realistic. On several occasions, facilities people accidentally went into my crime scenes and didn't know, and immediately called the police, and they said, oh no, that's Professor Mauriello's crime scenes. Before those 3 crime scenes, I constructed dioramas. There's a kitchen scene, bedroom scene, there's a hotel garage. I used the crime scene dollhouses for 19 years. That was a long time. I mean, I've been doing this for almost 48 years.
Some type of food that you would have choked on, like toast. And I wanted
of the dollhouses, they were great because we didn't have anything else. But you couldn't photograph it, you couldn't sketch it. Fingerprints were impossible because we're talking about a 1-inch scale. They really couldn't step into the crime scene. Now the students are actually participating in crime scene investigation and they're doing the work that they would really do in a real situation.
One of those nails are gone.
Yep.
Have you found that?
Yeah, in the back seat.
That could be really valuable because it may have been taken off when she was fighting with whoever did this.
The objective is that they've learned and understood the material. I get a lot of feedback from students and they say, hey, I'll never forget my experience because I've actually used it. I've had former students who are now lawyers who have come to me and said, hey, because of something I learned in your class, it made a difference when I was in the courtroom. I believe it's beneficial for a student to touch whatever they're learning, no matter what the course is. I think they get a better appreciation.